Namaste. My name is Rui Simra. I'm an international meditation master. Today I want to speak. We don't need intelligence, common sense is enough. So I by myself, I think I have an IQ from Anna. 130, so this means I have an IQ from 120 or so around. And actually, I have enough intelligence for myself. So the thing is that I use my common sense in every area of my life. And so that even an IQ from 110 or from 100 would be enough for myself. And actually, we look everywhere, common sense is nearly everywhere switched off. And this I had watched as a child, and I was totally confused why they're not using their common sense. So there was a priest, a Catholic priest, and the farmer was swimming in a lake. And then they saw that a group of girls were approaching them. And what they should do, so they were swimming nude, no? And quite painful also, embarrassing. So they rushed out of the lake, no? And towards the house, no? And the priest was covering his sexual organ, and the farmer said, "For what? Nobody knows your sexual organ. Cover your face." Okay, as the next example, there was a professor lecturing his knowledge on a boat, on a ship, and then the ship crashed in a reef, broke and sank. So, as the professor could not swim, then one student asked, "For what is your knowledge good?" Okay. There's a great Tibetan quote. If you can solve a problem through thinking, then this is not a problem. If you can't solve through thinking a problem, for what is thinking good? Just relax. The solution is there. Nothing wrong. That is the magic of life. Normally we see common sense is very seldom used, and I will give you an example. No? If we think that we don't need a health lifestyle, or if we think that the intention of the doctors is to heal us, yes, rather more no and nothing from that if he would heal us. You lose one patient, for instance. If we think we do the comfortable things, this means we choose to be lazy, make no workout, that we don't learn anything, taking just drugs, instead to do the opposite thing, then for sure I will question that. Is there any common sense? The other thing is, if we use our common sense and equally like to think intelligent, then we question ourselves, we question everything to get a better answer for our life. This means if a politician is speaking, then we ask, Is it really true? Who will profit from that? Or if we like to have this, is it really necessary for us? Should we change our life? Makes this us happy? And what I watch regardless was what some politicians are saying, that people just trust him, even he's lying always. And then I understand, if a political leader is speaking switched off common sense, and so that they can do everything with us. Only 5 or 10% question the political leader and find out that he, what he's doing is so bad. And mainly what they're doing is so bad for the population. This brings us to the attributes of intelligent thinking or common sense. If we not dare to question the political leader or any leader, then for sure we have fear. And true thinking or intelligent thinking is to think fearless and free, regardless in which direction. And this is very dangerous for political leaders, for instance, that the people are doing such things. So I'm for sure, I'm on the red list. And this long time. This means fearless thinking. And fear is always a bad advisor, that we think in every direction. And then we can think out of the box and find new solution. And not to make always the same thing. And then expecting better results. We have to change our acting, our thinking, to get great results. It's just so simple. So the next attribute is to be honest. And if you're not honest, how we can apply common sense? If you have fear, how we can apply common sense or true thinking or really, really thinking? Then we will find out by ourselves that we're kidding ourselves, that other people kid me. I can, as I find out very fast who is lying, very, very fast, because I'm honest to myself, honest to other people, this for sure that's easy. And if you're not honest, there's no intelligence at all in us. And if we are really fearless think and honest, then we have more intelligence than every genius. It means think in every direction. Okay. And I want to motivate you to this. There's another great story. I don't know if it's from the surface also. There was a guy who watched that in the OR somebody was poisoning the well water. And he found out that everybody who was drinking this water would get stupid. Okay, the mass is always stupid, so they have drunk this water, everybody, but not this guy. This guy was warning, don't drink this water, you're getting crazy, you're getting mad. At the end, the mass was saying, you drink this water or we execute you. You see? This you have seen always with Jesus or with all Cassandra and so on. the 2 or 3% know it, can think in every direction. 5% to 10% find out what is wrong, but cannot act in the right direction. This is the difference. The other 90% fear to think, not honest. Okay. Okay. Thank you that I could motivate you, or I hope so, and bye.